This is the new Shogun 7 monitor and recorder from Atomos.
Cinema 5D at NAB 2019 is brought to you by B&H, the professional source for all your video needs. CVP, the leading specialist in creative cine, video and photo solutions. Laowa, unique cinema and photography lenses. Fujinon, ultimate optical performance. And SERP, better films.
Hi, this is Nino from Cinema 5D. We're here at NAB 2019 at the Atomos booth with Jeremy.
Hey man, how are you going?
Well, I haven't seen you in a while.
I know. Yeah. Like,
let's talk about your new Shogun recorder,
yep.
The Shogun 7. So this looks exactly like the Shogun Inferno that everybody knows.
Yes.
What's new about this one?
Okay, so all the same functions with a couple of plus pluses. We're using the same LCD, which is a tried and true, really high quality LCD that we sourced from LG many years ago.
Full HD?
Full HD. It's 1920x1200. And obviously we use the bottom pixels for the UI. And in that endeavor, we've learned a lot about screen technology. And we had an edge backlight that we were trying to adjust for the shadow details and things. And we could curve them in digitally, but we couldn't really map across the screen. And you know that TVs have been trying to do that for a long time with, they call it dynamic backlight, you know, zoned backlight. So we thought about a couple of years ago, well, we should look into that. How do we develop our own technology there and kind of give ourselves a lead? And this is the coming to fruition of it. 360 zones. So we moved the LEDs from the side of the unit, which is all screens pretty much, except for the latest TVs. It's only like a year and a half ago Samsung put this out, right? And then behind that, we take those away and we put 360 of them behind the screen. And what that allows us to do is switch these on and these ones off. But not only that, we can turn them on in incremental intensity so that you do really see that depth of field in the image and the pop of the contrast that's popping out at you, which is what really your eye uses, that brightness differential to give you that depth in many ways. So of course it's not 3D on the screen, but god damn it, you can really see that depth of field.
Yeah, a lot of people are asking, you know, obviously this is probably still an 8-bit display.
Yes.
Because you have a lot of, not a lot, but there's a couple of very high-end, very expensive HDR displays on the market, which are usually bigger, but they're like $30,000, 10-bit.
Yeah, yeah.
And you managed to, you know, have something that, it's close to that, it's 15 stops of dynamic range, which is more than most of those HDR displays claim for much less money.
Yes, correct. And the reason we can do that is they're using a technology which is like insanely clever, right? Where you put two LCDs together and then you either double the intensity or let the backlight through through the two, or you close one of them to get black. So you get this kind of contrast range that gives you the number of stops that you can utilize. Well, we're achieving the same thing, not their pixel for pixel is the difference. Mm-hmm. We will get on some
like
areas.
Bigger areas.
Yeah, we're bigger areas. We're not, so we're going, all right, so over here is normal LED, edge lit.
Yeah.
We're here, they're over here.
Okay.
The difference between us is not the contrast ratio difference, it's the ability to apply that per pixel. Mm-hmm. Our ability is like, I don't know, I can't remember the numbers the engineer said, like 20 pixels by 20 pixels or something across. You can divide by 360 both ways and you'll see it, what that is. But that means we're pretty accurate, you know, we're kind of 50% to their accuracy. Mm-hmm. But for $1,500 versus $30,000, you decide.
Yeah.
You know, you're gonna get, at least if you know that that's the case, you can at least compensate for it if you have to. But that's why we think this is the right technology moving forward. Samsung, Sony, Panasonic, they all have moved that direction. So there's a lot of know-how out there, algorithms out there. Dolby's heavily involved in that type of representing the image. Mm-hmm. So teaming up with them for our Dolby Vision output announcement was huge. Learned a lot. They're a bunch of very clever people over at Dolby. So yeah, we're very happy with the quality of it. We think it rivals those screens in its capacity as a 7-inch monitor, because we've got some advantages, right? It's only 7-inch. 360 across 7-inch, it's a lot. It's pretty small.
Yeah.
If we did 360 zones across their 31-inch, it's going to look a lot different. There'll be haloing around it, and a lot of people have tried that before.
So as a DP, when would I use that?
All right. I would say once you see it, you're going to be using it all the time, but it's to keep your creative intent on how it's going to look on that Dolby Vision TV.
Okay, so basically if you're finishing for an actual big HDR display,
Which probably some of your footage is going to go there anyway, right?
Yeah, you want to look at it on this one.
That's right. And I would say you probably want, we can swap to SDR if you want, but you probably want an SDR monitor here to show you the difference between
Okay. Good. Apart from the display, what else is new? You have the new interface on there?
Yeah, we've got the new interface, so it's Atomos 10, so it inherits that.
Will this also come to the Shogun Inferno?
We can. I think I want to offer it as an option. I've got a bunch of customers saying, don't change it on me. So I'll probably have to say toggle.
Oh, yeah. You can. I mean, if you can switch it in preferences or something.
We could. We could. I don't know whether we can store that many bitmap files in there to do too. You might have to choose at the start, maybe. But those things
are all in development.
Yeah. And we're hearing you, the requests, just like the SDI module for Ninja 5, you know. Mm-hmm. We really do care about what the customers are asking. And it helps sales when we release them, right? So it's a good partnership. So keep the requests coming.
And there's something else you have, like a multi, like it's like a switch option.
Yeah, it's the same as a Sumo, but now asynchronous, and Sumo will get that at the same time. Mm-hmm. So that'll be shipping in a couple of weeks. This is shipping end of May, beginning of June. And the first thing I want to do is show you the four different inputs. It's 3G HD 60p with Genlock in and out, as well as recording of the program stream. And then on the program stream, comes up with the four, you choose which one you start on, you cue the next one, you fade between them.
Oh, cool.
And then it switches.
So how does it work? You can record all four streams simultaneously?
Correct. And the program stream.
And the program stream.
And at the end of it, you got this synced, asynchronous, no matter what the sources were, project that is XML based.
Then change.
Yeah. And then you chuck it in Final Cut or Adobe if you're using ProRes. Not ProRes RAW yet. And you're away, right? I mean, that is a huge time saver. With a big touchscreen on a Sumo or a little one there for your productions when you need it.
Cool. I think you already mentioned about pricing and availability.
$14.99. And we'll ship it out at the end of May. It'll be like June before the customer gets them.
Awesome. Thank you, Jeremy.
No problem.
Thanks for watching.
Cinema 5D.
And stay tuned to Cinema 5D for more from NAB 2019. Win $5,000 worth of gear in our NAB 2019 giveaway together with Serb and Joby. You can win a Genie 3X's Pro Slider Epic Kit, a Magic Carpet Carbon Fiber Slider, and a Gorillapod with Genie Mini. To enter the giveaway, simply click the link below and follow the instructions. All winners will be drawn on April 30th. Good luck and stay tuned to Cinema 5D.